Praise the Lord, everyone. Oh, praise the Lord, everyone. The Bible said that everything that have breath, praise ye the Lord. I'm so glad to come before you this morning. Amen. This is Pastor Anthony Rapolock. Amen. The pastor of New Beginnings Church of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. A place that we started over 6.5 years ago. Amen. To let people know you can have a new beginning.
Yes.
You can have a fresh start. Amen. You can, hallelujah, start all over again.
Yeah.
You can just lay yourself before God and say, Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. And we all need the mercy of God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But I thank God because he said, if anyone be in Christ,
2
Corinthians 5th chapter 17 verse,
yeah,
if any person be in Christ, they are a new creature.
Yes, sir.
Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. All right, we're going to go into the Word of God. We're going to go right into the Word of God today. Amen. Psalm 96 chapter verses 1 through 9. Psalms 96 chapter, beginning at the first verse through the ninth verse. While you're turning, I thank God for how he has kept us from last Sunday up to this present time.
Amen.
Amen. Many people have left here. If we call their name from last Sunday, somebody would fail to answer. Amen. But because of God's mercy, we are still here. And I believe we are here on kingdom business today. Amen. To be in the house of the Lord, to give praises to our God for the great things that he has done.
Amen.
Psalm 96, beginning at verse 1. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Sing unto the Lord. Bless his name. Show forth his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all people. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. All the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. All give unto the Lord, O ye kindreds of people, give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. Like the user thought on today, a fresh praise.
Yes, sir.
A fresh praise. Father, I thank you for this time to go into your word. We ask God you to look down upon us as we break the bread of life. Feed us as we feed your people, O Lord. I stand in need of your help today, O Lord. I preach not myself, but Christ Jesus, crucified, resurrected. I thank you, O God, for this word today. I bind up the hand of the enemy and anything that will try to hinder this word today. Bless us, we shall be blessed. Keep us, we shall be kept. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, we pray. Everyone say amen.
Amen.
A fresh praise.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
It's all right, bro.
Hallelujah.
Preach.
The Bible says, the fourth verse says, for the Lord is great and greatly
to be praised.
To be praised.
Amen.
In a great way.
Yeah.
Amen. There's one thing to tell me, thank you. But when God do something for you, my God, you ought to say, thank you. Amen. Magnified 100-fold. Amen. A fresh praise. When I think of something fresh, y'all bear with me as I build up to the core of the message on today.
Amen.
When I think of something fresh, I think of something that is new. How many of us have ever went and got a new car and it's shiny, it got that new look?
Amen.
And then you open up the door, it got that new smell.
Mm.
Amen. Oh, man, this is nice. Amen.
Yeah.
How many of you have ever got a cake out of the oven? Amen. And it's fresh.
Amen.
And that first slice, my wife and my daughter give me the first slice of that. Oh, man, it's just something like it. Amen. So, there's nothing like it. How many of you love fresh veggies? Amen. Amen. That fresh, there's just something about fresh.
Yes, sir.
When something is fresh, it is new.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
It has not been used before.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It has not been duplicated before.
Go ahead, brother.
It is the original. Amen.
Yes.
So the opposite of something fresh is stale. The opposite of something new is old. Something that arrives on time, the opposite of that is late.
Go ahead.
How many of you ever got a cake out of the oven late?
Uh-huh.
It ain't right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. If something is not growing, it is stunted. Amen. It is not, the growth has been stunted. But when something is fresh, amen, it's new, amen. It is growing, amen, in its own time, amen. So the message of the day is a fresh praise. I remember back in the day, we used to have testimony service on Sunday night. And thank God for the saints of old. Thank God for them. Many of them are going on. But some of them had the same testimony every time. We as little fellas sitting on the front row, I can almost go word for word what they're going to say. Thank God for being in the house of the Lord today. Thank God for the pastor. I thank God how he kept me. I ask you to go to know the work of prayer. I pray my strength for the Lord. Amen. They don't say more than that, but I just remember to where sometimes if you do the same thing the same way all the time, if you don't be careful, it can be stagnant.
Amen.
Amen. But I'm talking about a fresh praise on today.
Amen.
Amen. We have a message today that I hope will put you into thinking about the times that we are living in. Amen. I heard there was an article, he was on the radio or on the internet, that it said that 70% of the people that have not been going to church since the pandemic, 70 people, I ain't talking about visitors, 70% of the churchgoers will not return back to a physical church. They will continue to worship online. And that may be fine for some, but we have to be so careful
Amen.
About that. Because fellowship with one another, because the Bible speaks about us coming together. Amen. Fellowship commands relationship. Amen. And you can't have a relationship if you don't have fellowship. Y'all count that?
Amen. Yes, sir.
You can't have fellowship without relationship. And you can't have a relationship without fellowship. So sometimes the enemy, amen, in his slick way, calls us to be isolated on the island by ourselves. Amen. But we try to listen to things on the radio, on the internet, on television, amen. And we have to be so careful that and be aware that the enemy is setting us up to take us out.
Amen.
If we are not able to get to the house of the Lord, I want to encourage you to let you know you must be committed, you must be diligent, and you must make the sacrifices to stay before God, or you will get spiritually weak. Amen. I got a pocket full of amen by myself. Amen. You will get weak. When we are not able to come together, you're going to have to do something different to maintain your walk with God. Amen. So when God, amen, moves, we got to be ready to move also. I want to encourage you
amen.
To make your calling and your election sure with God. Make sure that your hand is in the master's hand. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The devil is slick. And don't you know he know how to set you up. Some of you right now under the sound of my voice, the devil is setting you up right now. You are cool, you are fine, you are comfortable, you're listening to the message, amen, in your pajamas, in your curls, amen, and everything is fine. But you got to be careful, amen. The Bible said that the devil come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I came that you may have life, and that you may have it more abundantly. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
And I want you to remember that. While we in our isolated places, think about this. How much praise have you given to God? Well, I pray. I didn't say pray. I said praise. How do we praise God when we are by ourselves? How do we praise God when we the Lone Ranger? How do we praise God with nobody else around, amen, to sing the songs of Zion? Nobody else there to clap our hands, amen, and give God glory and praise. That's why I say we have to be committed, amen, in this walk with God when we are all out there by ourselves.
Amen.
Amen. We can do it with the help of God. But I want to encourage you, amen, to have a fresh praise.
Amen.
What are you saying, Pastor? I mean, I'm like, thank God for what he has done in the past. But we need to thank God for today. This is the day the Lord has made. This day. What you're talking about, you might have forced for the day. This day. Thank God for this day. Thank God I got my right mind today.
Amen.
Thank God I got food on my table today. Thank God for the clothes, the shoes on my feet today. Thank God I have the active use of my limbs today.
Amen.
Keep your praise fresh in God, I say.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for every paycheck you get.
Mm-hmm.
When the last time you thank God for your paycheck?
Yes, sir.
When the last time you thank God for your Social Security check?
Yes.
For your retirement check? For your stimulus, whatever? We have to keep our praise fresh before God.
Yes.
Because let me tell you something, trouble will come in all our lives.
Yes.
And it's good to have a praise before God before trouble comes. Hallelujah.
Yes.
In 2 Chronicles, there was a king by the name of King Jehoshaphat. Pray with me, Elder Tucker. King Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. The Bible says he woke up one morning and the children of the Amor, the Ammonites, the Moabites, he was greatly outnumbered. He said, oh my God, what do I do when I don't know what to do? He was perplexed in his mind.
Yeah.
Amen. He had trouble in his kingdom, and he didn't know what to do. But thank God, amen, there was a man of God by the name of Jehaziel. He said, O king, the battle is not yours,
yes, sir.
But it's the Lord's.
Yes, sir.
Now, we're going to prepare for battle. But we're not going to prepare for battle the old way. See, sometimes God do something fresh. We got to be ready to roll with God. Amen.
Amen.
God used Jehaziel. He said, he didn't call for the war again. He didn't call for the horsemen. He didn't call for the foot soldiers. He called for the choir.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Somebody ought to be shouting right now.
Yes, sir.
He called for the choir. Come on, we're going to sing a praise to God.
Yes, sir.
All your thanks to the Lord,
yes,
for his mercy and due bill.
Yes.
And that's how they went out to battle with the choir. All your thanks unto the Lord, for his mercy and due bill.
Yes.
Who knows what God can do?
Yes.
And the Bible says it caused the enemy to be confused in their mind.
Yes, sir.
They begin to fight one another. They begin to ambush one another.
Hallelujah.
What are you saying, brother preacher? The battle is not yours.
Yes.
The battle is the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Keep your fresh praise. Give God the glory every day. Let's change our mindset. Let us get out of that whole mentality. Oh, I got something for you, man. Sometimes we look at things going around. I hope none of you have said this. But some of you have said, things beginning to look kind of bleak. Things beginning to look kind of rough. Things beginning to look like they ain't going to get no better.
Man.
Get your chicken head up and look up like an eagle,
yes,
and say, I see victory.
Yes,
I see victory ahead.
Yeah.
I don't know what you see out here looking like a chicken, but have the eagles do that, things is going to get better.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It may not get better for them, but it's going to get better for me.
Yeah.
I belong to God, and he belongs to me. Let the church say amen.
Amen. That's right.
Why are you in this journey?
Yeah.
Let me tell you what the chicken feeding on. The chicken is feeding on negative stuff.
Yes, sir.
They feeding on negative feed. Things don't look like he's going to get no better.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But then, get yourself around positive people.
Yeah.
Amen. I see
yes,
a better day.
Yes, sir.
Somebody in the neighbor say, man, I'm broke. Tell them you ain't going to stay broke.
Yes, sir.
Reverse whatever negative they say, reverse it.
Reverse it.
If they say, man, I'm going to feel bad tomorrow. I got to go to my doctor. Speak life into them.
Yes.
You're going to be doing better.
Yes, sir.
Amen. When negative come, push that aside. Amen. Then give them something else. Fight the good fight of faith. Glory to God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. In fresh praise, we don't have to accept the negative that the enemy throw at us.
That's right.
Fear comes upon us at times. It do. When we get that call from the doctor. Amen. When we get that call from the doctor saying, I've done all that I can do. We're going to have to just hope for the best. And people's heart, amen, draw faith. They might be confused. But I want to encourage you, have a fresh praise unto God.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
That God, you brought me this far.
Yes, sir.
I believe you'll take me on.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Maybe you don't know this or not. Maybe you don't know this. But this world is not our home. Saints of God, this world is not my home. We are pilgrims and strangers passing through. I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to the day that I leave this world. I'm not ready to go right now. I'm going to do some things for my family. Amen. But we as saints of God, remember, this is not our heaven.
Yes, sir.
I'm looking forward to that place.
Yes, sir.
Where the wicked will see some trouble.
Yes, sir.
And the weary will be at rest.
Yes,
where there will always be hiding, hiding, and never goodbye. Yes. God said, I'm going to wipe all tears from your eyes.
Yes,
there will be no more pain, yes, no more sorrow. Hallelujah. For the former things will be passed away. I want to go to that place. Amen. Where corruption is going to put on incorruption.
Yeah.
Where mortal is going to put on immortality.
Yeah.
Oh, death, where is your stain?
Yeah.
Oh, grave, where is your victory? Be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. There's coming a better day for the people of God.
Yes, sir.
Well, brother, pastor, so many people don't believe. Tell them Romans 3 and 4. If some don't believe, do that make the gospel of God of none effect? He said, let every man be alive, and my word be true. Hallelujah. I'm going to stand for Jesus.
Amen.
I'm just going to stand for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I don't care what nobody else say. I'm going to stand for Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Testing time is here. And trying times sometimes squeeze the very last bit of water out of the towel. Amen. But don't worry. Don't be afraid. Everything's going to be all right.
Amen.
I said everything.
Yes.
Everything.
Hallelujah.
Money problems.
Yes.
Health problems.
Yes.
Job problems.
Yes.
Children problems.
Yes.
Everything.
Everything
is going to be all right.
Amen.
Yeah, I feel all right in my soul today. I feel like going up. Hallelujah. Don't get so disappointed in this world down here. This is the world down here. Don't be so disappointed when people don't treat you right. This is their world.
Amen.
Don't be disappointed when the people in the restaurant bring you a meal that you didn't order and you just fly off the handle. Don't be so disappointed.
Amen.
Everything's not going to go our way down here.
It's not.
Don't fly off the handle if you get a flat tire.
Mm-hmm.
Just get the tire fixed. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to be there for work. Let me work. It's better you take care of your business and be safe when you get to work. Amen.
Amen.
Let's settle ourselves down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
See what happened in the times? We think what we see. We see these things happen all around us, on TV, online, and our mindset will follow just what that thing is doing if we don't have a foundation in God.
That's right.
What do the Word of God say about it? Amen.
Mm-hmm.
The Word of God is our roadmap that can lead us safely to heaven. A fresh praise. When things come upon you and you never experienced these type things before and you begin to wonder, what do I do now? Remember to have a fresh praise.
Yes, sir.
Take a step back and say, Lord, I don't know how this thing is going to work out,
yes, sir,
but I'm going to thank you in advance.
Praise.
I know you've done it before. You brought me across the rivers before. You led me across the mountain before. You took me through the valley of the shadow of death before. And Lord, I'm going to praise you right now. But I'm going to make this next step in Jesus' name. I don't know what it's going to take. I don't know how I'm going to come out of here. But I do believe, oh God, that everything is going to be all right. Because I'm walking in faith. I'm talking in faith. I'm living in faith. Amen. Faith, hallelujah. We must have faith. The Bible says, without faith, it is impossible. Woo! It's impossible to please God.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
You just got to keep going.
Yes, sir.
Somebody say, keep going.
Keep going.
Sometimes you just got to keep going.
Keep going.
Just keep going. Sometimes you got to keep going, and you got to wipe the tears from your eye.
Yeah.
But you keep going in Jesus' name.
Yes,
hallelujah. How do you know about that? I've been there, done that. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. I ain't telling you what I experienced it. I experienced these things before. But I kept going in Jesus' name. And as I kept going, my muscles got bigger. I ain't talking about physical. I'm talking about my spiritual muscles.
Yes,
as I kept going, I got a little bigger. I got a little stronger. I got a little smarter. I got a little wiser. And I said, for God I live. And for God I die.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm still here today.
Yes,
glory to God. I thank you.
Yes.
A fresh praise.
Amen.
Give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name, and bring an offering, and come into his courts. Don't come to God empty-handed. And I'm not talking about a great amount. God recognizes what you give. Amen. Give. Give a praise. Give a financial offering. Give a blessing. Amen. Something that money can't buy. A phone call to somebody sick. Amen. Small things. Bring it offering to the Lord. Amen. And lift it to the Lord. And God recognizes what we do. For what you do to the least of these, you do it unto God. One writer said, Lord, I didn't see you in prison. I didn't see you hungry. I didn't see you naked. Jesus said, when you see the least of these right now, when you see it, you've done it to the least of them, you do it unto me. My God, my God. So much more I want to say, but I'm going to leave it right there. I would have just encouraged, amen, just for a second. My brothers and my sisters in Christ Jesus, let's stop bickering, fighting against one another, with issues, and love one another. Mm-hmm. If it ain't gonna build up, what good is it going to bring discord? Let's love one another. The world needs a light. And even if we fighting and bickering over one another and things, they ain't gonna wanna come into that. Let's love one another. Show love. Take the low road sometimes. You don't have to take the high road all the time. Take the low road. My father used to say, we can disagree, but don't be disagreeable. Mm-hmm. For the common good, let's have love one for another. The church is supposed to set the example of love in the world. The church. The world is not going to set the example for the church. So let us be mindful of who we are and whose we are in Jesus' name. I say that in love, and I hope you receive it in love, in Jesus' name. Thank God for you today. I hope you got something out of your scattered remarks. A fresh praise.
Yeah.
Amen. Keep your praise fresh.
Yeah.
Think about every day the good Lord give to you. Every day with Jesus. I didn't understand the church mothers when they sang that song. Every day with Jesus. Sweeter than the day before. Every day with Jesus. I love him more. Jesus, save and keep me. He's the one that I adore. Every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Thank God. I love you today. May God bless you. Keep you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. You'll find Jesus, he said, when you search for me with all your heart. Life is in Jesus Christ. Thank God for you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
I love you, Lord.